Hello, everyone. It's Sunday. I'm Kristen. This is Jack. He's here to talk with me about communication. I think communication in any relationship is one of the most important things. If you don't have that, then I think you will be in a lot of trouble. So I think when Jack first came out to me, we had a lot of trouble communicating how we felt, and for me, I think I was learning, I was researching everything that was going to happen with him and his transition and things he would go through, and I was worried about telling some of my feelings because I didn't want to upset him or say the wrong thing, or so I think that I held back in the beginning a little. I think that for you, how was it for you in the beginning?
I didn't really talk a lot. I didn't really talk a lot about my emotions. I kind of got trapped in my head and stopped communicating how I was feeling and what I was going through and what I needed from her or my concerns to Kristen. Not for a particular reason or because I was mad at her, but only because I just got trapped in my head and I was feeling a little depressed and kind of worried about my transition and things like that. So communication kind of came to a standstill for a few months.
Yeah, it took us a while in the beginning. I say the first 6 months, we were nestling. The first 6 months, I think we had trouble. We had trouble communicating about our sex life. I think that was a huge thing. I am very sensitive. We would have little dry spells. And instead of saying, hey, what's wrong, or, you know, did I do something, or whatever, I was passive-aggressive at times, making stupid little comments that didn't help the situation, but I think a lot of my insecurities didn't let me open up and talk about how I was feeling and, you know, about it. How about you in the sexual area?
Part of my problem at that time was I was struggling a lot with dysphoria, so I didn't really want to tell Kristen. I didn't want to talk about it because if I talked about it, it was real. And I didn't want to become vulnerable and open that much of myself up to Kristen. Excuse me. And so instead I just never initiated, and, you know, physical touch really kind of made me nervous and made me uncomfortable. And so in turn, you know, Kristen became very self-conscious and thought that it was because I didn't find her attractive. And instead of telling me that, she would make these smart-ass comments in private and in public that would just make me really uncomfortable. And what I expected from her was to just know that I was going through a hard time and to just be sensitive of it. And for as much as she knows me and knows when I'm down or knows when, you know, things aren't right, she's not going to be able to read my mind. And so I just finally came out and just told her, you know, this is what I'm struggling with. This is why sex right now makes me uncomfortable, why I don't always initiate. And, you know, it was really about realizing that it was really hurting our relationship to not talk about what I was feeling. And then I think that Kristen realized that I was really sensitive to how she approached the subject, and then I realized that she was really sensitive if I didn't approach the subject. So in that sense, we both compromised and realized that we needed to be bigger people and just stop holding on to those insecurities and just talk to each other. And sex has been, sex is great.
Well, yeah.
That's just, I mean, but I think that in terms of talking about sex, that it's so much easier now for both of us.
We both kind of let our guard down and just say what we need to say and...
Say what you need to say.
Right, John Mayer. So I think we're a lot better. We have done a lot of work. It takes a lot of work. And just always try to be respectful of the other person and try to put yourself in their shoes. But your partner also has to know that you are not a mind reader. And you don't know what they're thinking, and, you know, your partner is new to this, too, and...
Well, I think this is transition aside, too. I think that transition just adds a layer of complexity mm-hmm. to how two people need to communicate or relearn how to communicate, you know?
Yeah. I struggled with feeling that I never said the right thing to you.
And I struggled with never hearing what I wanted to hear, right. Which is an impossible expectation that you put on your partner. It's just not possible. You're never going to hear everything that you want to hear. And I think that when you not lower your expectations, but actually make them reasonable, and just, you know, you have to work with your partner to help them get to know you, to help them understand your needs. I think that when you realize that, it kind of opens up a whole new avenue of just... I mean, the word communication is stupid. I think that it's really about listening.
It's true.
I think that what's more important about communication is not talking, it's listening. Mm-hmm. I think that I remember so many times when Kristen and I would argue and, you know, I would say something and I could tell that she wasn't paying attention because she was too busy trying to figure out what her comeback was going to be. And so many times I would not listen because I didn't want to hear it, I was annoyed, or I was over it. And I think that what's important is listening, really, really listening, and hearing what your partner has to say, and actually respond in a way that's effective, that's appropriate, that's mature, that's actually going to help solve the problem and not make it worse. Like... arguing back and forth about, I don't know, just silly shit.
Silly shit.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, do you agree with me?
I agree.
What else do you have to say on the topic, Kristen?
I think one thing that has helped me and that I've changed about myself is I am somebody who... if I get into an argument with somebody or something's bothering me, I want to handle it now, right now. Get it over with, let's do whatever we're going to do about it and move on. And Jack isn't that way. And so that was a big adjustment for me. I worked really hard trying to, because I say really off the wall crap when I'm really mad. So I think it's better for me also to just step back, take a break, and come back to it later, as long as we come back to it later. Because there were times when we wouldn't come back to it later, and that's something huge with me. I always want to work it out and make sure it gets talked about and not just fall to the side.
Yeah, and I think that my wanting to walk away and talk about it later was being interpreted as a dismissal and as a gesture of not caring. But it was more of, I am really fucking pissed off right now, and we're not going to get anywhere if we're leading this conversation with emotions, because we're just not going to listen to each other, and we're not going to get to a point where we can have a healthy discussion about the problem. It's just going to be about, you hurt my feelings, why did you say that bullshit? And so I think that if emotions are playing a huge part in how you're talking and your reactions to things, just walk away. Mm-hmm. It's not going to hurt to just calm the fuck down mm-hmm. and come back to it later. And sometimes you don't go back to it, and that's not good either. But, you know, then you can just drink.
Don't just drink.
Just drink. That's why I'm drinking right now, because we fought.
No, we didn't.
No, we didn't.
We're going to fight now.
Naked.
Anyway, so that's my video. If you have any questions for me, feel free to leave a comment or message me on Facebook. And that's it, right? That's it. Have a good rest of your weekend, everyone. I'll see you next Sunday. Bye.
Dismiss.
Oh. Oh my goodness.
Get close.